Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Tanukal C, Assistant Professor from Government Degree College, Dharampur, from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla. Today, we are going to talk on module Corporate Culture Based on Values from the paper Human Values and Indian Ethos. After studying this module, the students shall be able to learn about the following: Culture, Characteristics of culture, corporate culture, components of corporate culture, types of corporate culture, importance of a healthy corporate culture, organizational value system, functions of values. Introduction. Corporate culture refers to the beliefs and behaviors that determine the interaction between companies' employees and management, and also handles the outside business transactions. Corporate culture is implied and it develops with the time, and it develops from the cumulative traits of the people which are hired by the company. The culture of a company is reflected in its dress code, business hours, office setup, employees' benefits, turnover, hiring decisions, treatment of clients, and every other aspect of the business. With the more and more awareness of the organizational culture concept, the term corporate culture was developed in 1980s and was made widely known in 1990s. The corporate culture was earlier used by the managers, sociologists, and other academics for describing the features of the company. But with the passage of time, the corporate culture became wider in scope. Now, the corporate culture term comprises of management strategies, employee communication and employer-employee relationships, work environment, attitude of people working in the organization, and other aspects of the working environment. Value system is very important for all the systems of the society. It is presumed that in all human affairs, where there is involvement of money, there is greed, and where there is greed, corruption of various types arises, such as scams, fraud, cheating, and other unethical plotting. The sole aim of the business is to earn profit and more money by any means, whether it is ethical or unethical. In today's competitive environment, the economic competition in globalized and liberalized business world, in the view of earning more and more profits, the managers sometimes undermine the long-cherished ethical value system and uses the shortcuts for attaining the quick profits to rush forward in the competitive environment. In today's market-led competitive economy, the material well-being and wealth maximization has to come to occupy the central stage, where the values are fast growing in the back seat, and it ultimately leads to the multifarious socio-economic problems of great dimensions in our socio-economic system. Corruption is widespread and all unethical means are being resorted to amass money. Moreover, the corporate affairs of the companies and business transactions are fastly becoming dusky as the business deals are following unethical means and practices. Therefore, there is urgent need to strengthen our core value system so that the ethical management of business system is protected, preserved, and promoted. Corporate culture refers to the beliefs and behaviors that undermines the interaction between the company's employees and management, and also handles the outside business transactions. Corporate culture is implied and it develops with the time, and it develops from the cumulative traits of the people which are hired by the company. The culture of the company is reflected in its dress code, business hours, office setup, employees' benefits, turnover, hiring decisions, treatment of clients, and every other aspect of the business. Culture. Culture is the characteristics and knowledge of a particular group of people as defined by everything from language, religion, social habits, and music. Culture is the system of shared knowledge by a relatively large group of people. Culture is communication, and communication is culture. Culture can be defined in the broadest sense as the totality of persons' learned accumulated experience, which is socially transmitted behavior through social learning. A culture is the sum of total of learned behaviors of a group of people that are generally considered to be tradition of that people and are transmitted from generation to generation. It is collective programming of the mind that distinguishes the members of one group from another. Characteristics of culture. Culture has five broad characteristics. It is learned, shared, based on symbols, integrated, and dynamic. Corporate culture. Corporate culture refers to the beliefs and behaviors that determines the interaction between company's employees and management, and also handles the outside business transactions. With the more and more awareness of organizational culture concept, the term corporate culture was developed in 1980s and was made widely known in 1990s. The corporate culture was earlier used by the managers, sociologists, and other academics for describing the features of the company. But with the passage of time, the corporate culture became wider in scope. Now, the corporate culture term comprises of management strategies, employee communication, employer-employee relations, work environment, attitude of people working in the organization, and other aspects of the working environment. Types of corporate culture. Corporate culture refers to the collective attitudes, beliefs, and codes of behavior which prevail among the staff of the business. The culture is generated by individuals and their relationships with each other, and also by the basic goals, orientations, and context of the business. Culture is the most important element of the business that helps one business to be distinguished from the other one. The corporate cultures are of following types. First is traditional culture. This is the oldest approach to the corporate environment. A traditional culture means the employees have defined roles and relationships. They follow a proper chain of command. The orders are given from top-level management and are followed by lower levels of management. They don't have much scope for deviations. In these types of organizations, the procedures to be followed are properly standardized and are strictly enforced. Components of great corporate culture. The benefits of strong corporate culture are always supported by social science. Each culture is unique, and there are numerous factors that affect the creation of organizational culture. Some of those components are discussed as follows. First one is vision. A great culture begins with the vision and mission statement. These simple turns of the phrase guides the values of the companies and provides with the purpose. These purposes also affect the decisions to be taken by the employees. The good and proper vision statement helps the customers, suppliers, and stakeholders. A vision statement is simple and fundamental element of the culture. Next is values. The values of the company are the core of its culture. Vision communicates the purpose of the company, and values offer a set of guidelines on behavior and mindset needed to achieve that vision. Next is practices. Of course, values are of little importance unless they are enshrined in a company's practices. If an organization professes, "People are our greatest asset," it should also be ready to invest in the people in visible ways. Next is people. A company can only build a logical culture with its people who share their core values and also who possess their willingness to embrace those values. Next is place. Certain cities and countries have their local culture which help the organizations in building the organizational culture also. The culture with regard to place can be geographical or architectural. It will impart the values and behaviors of the people in a workplace. Next is highly skilled. In any organization which has skilled culture means that the people can get results directly from bottom level of employees. These highly skilled companies try to be ahead in competition and are big industrial units. The nature of this type of corporate culture involves constant revolving door type change and a high turnover rate. Innovative culture. An innovative corporate culture is opposite of the traditional corporate culture. In innovative culture, there are creative initiatives of employees and employees are also allowed deviations from standard procedures. Employees are also encouraged in the innovative culture. This type of environment is also a risky environment. The firms that attempt this type of culture must address the question of whether or not the risk gets paid by the occasional breakthrough. Social. A social corporate culture draws its strength from collaborative efforts, teamwork, and healthy, trusting relationship among the staff. A social corporate culture often emphasizes taking care of workers. This type of philosophy holds that it's worthwhile to pay employees a bit more than usual, to recognize and reward accomplishments, and to encourage participants from everywhere. Social businesses are often held together by a sense of meaning, identity, and pride that employees derive from their jobs. Importance of healthy corporate culture. Every organization has its own culture. The culture refers to the values and attitudes of employees in the business or organization. In business with an unhealthy culture, employees act as individuals performing their duties to meet their own needs. A healthy corporate culture values each employee in the organization regardless of his job duties, which results in employees working as a team to meet companies and their own personal needs. Healthy corporate culture improves the performance of business in number of areas. The importance of healthy corporate culture is explained as below. Employee retention. The employees of company which value their contributions have high morale and positive attitude. The positive attitude workers have high morale, and this also helps in reducing employee absenteeism. A healthy corporate culture can help a company retain valuable employees and reduce human resource cost. Reputation. Companies with a healthy corporate culture gain a positive reputation among potential workers, which may attract talented and skilled workers to the organization. In addition to attracting high-quality workers, a well-regarded business reputation allows company to charge a higher prices for products and services and increases the value of company in financial market. Customers may prefer to conduct business with the business with solid corporate reputation as well. Productivity. The improved morale of workers in a company with healthy corporate culture increases the productivity. When workers increase productivity, the financial health of organization improves and ultimately profits increases. Increase in productivity is a measure that illustrates efficiencies and effectiveness in the company. Employees benefit from increases in productivity with higher salaries in employee benefit programs. Quality. Healthy corporate culture encourages workers to deliver quality products and services. Companies with culture valuing highest standard create an atmosphere for workers to deliver products that meet those standards. The cultural standards for excellence are an important factor for creating a product or service with reputation for high quality. Organizational value system. Cooperation. Indian philosophy focuses more on cooperation and coordination. Instead of individual tough competition, which is in fact a feature of the Western thought. Family orientation. The value system of India is oriented toward family base. Even the grown-ups, while taking major decisions, consult their seniors about the issuers. Values are generally received through the cultural means by way of transmission from parents to children. Humility and respect for others. Indian ethos emphasizes humility and respect for others. Respect to all. It focuses on showing the respect to others and respect not only to fellow human beings but to objects as well. Self-management. Indian ethos believes that self-management is the essence of management. Before managing others effectively, a person should know how to manage himself. Only then he can manage others effectively. Functions of values. Values are generic experiences in social actions made up of both individual and social responses and attitudes. Values build up societies and integrate social relations. Values mold the ideal dimensions of personality and also influence the range and depth of culture. Values influence people's behavior and serve as a criteria for evaluating actions of others. Values have a great role to play in the conduct of social life. Values help in creating the norms to guide day-by-day behavior. Summary. Culture is the characteristics and knowledge of a particular group of people as defined by everything from language, religion, social habits, and music. Culture is the system of knowledge shared by a relatively large group of people. Culture is communication and communication is culture. Culture can be defined in the broadest sense as totality of persons' learned, accumulated experience, which is socially transmitted behavior through self-learning. A culture is the sum of total of the learned behaviors of a group of people that are generally considered to be tradition of that people and are transmitted from generation to generation. It is collective programming of the mind that distinguishes the members of one group from another. Corporate culture refers to the beliefs and behaviors that determines the interaction between the company's employees and management and also handles the outside business transactions. Corporate culture is implied and it develops with the time, and it also develops from the cumulative traits of people which are hired by the company. The culture of the company is reflected in its dress code, business hours, office setup, employees' benefits, turnover, hiring decisions, treatment of clients, and every other aspect of the business. With the more and more awareness of organizational culture, the term corporate culture was developed in 1980s and was made widely known in 1990s. The corporate culture was earlier used by the managers, sociologists, and other academics for describing the features of the company. But with the passage of time, the corporate culture became wider in scope. Now, the corporate culture term comprises of management strategies, employee communication, and employer-employee relations, work environment, attitude of people working in the organization, and other aspects of the working environment. Value system is very important for all the systems of the society. It is presumed that in all human affairs, where there is involvement of money, there is greed, and where there is greed, corruption of various types arises, such as scam, fraud, cheating, and other unethical plotting. The solo aim of business is to earn profit and more money by any means, whether it is ethical or unethical. In today's competitive environment, the economic competition in globalized and liberalized business world, in the view of earning more and more profits, the managers sometimes undermine the long-cherished ethical value system and use the shortcuts in attaining the quick profits to rush forward in the competitive environment. In today's market-led competitive economy, the material well-being and wealth maximization has come to occupy the central stage, where the values are fast growing in the back seat, and it ultimately leads to multifarious socio-economic problems of great dimensions in our socio-economic system. Thank you.